Let us continue solid state. In solid state, we will go for crystal structures. Now we will take Na2O, sodium oxide we will take. We will take Na2O, sodium oxide. Now let us compare sodium oxide crystal structure with CaF2 crystal structure. In CaF2 crystal structure, Ca2 plus forms FCC. F minus ions occupy all the tetrahedral voids. What do you say about Na2O by comparing with CaF2? What do you say about sodium oxide by comparing with CaF2? What do you say? In sodium oxide, which forms FCC do you say? In sodium oxide, which forms FCC? In the sodium oxide, oxide occupies all tetrahedral voids. You are saying oxide occupies all tetrahedral voids, you are saying. Sir, we will check. Now, here see that. If you take oxide occupies all tetrahedral voids, your point of view is oxide is occupying all tetrahedral voids. Sir, that we will check in there. Sir, now we will see. Okay. You are saying that oxide is occupying all tetrahedral voids. Sir, that means sodium ion forming FCC. That is the meaning. Whether this is correct or wrong, we have to check. Sir, sodium ions forming FCC means sodium ions will be 4 per unit cell. Per unit cell, 4 sodium ions. Oxide ions will be how much means 8. Oxide ions will be 8. Then what is the formula we are getting? NaO2 we are getting. Therefore, we can say it is incorrect, we can say. So we can say it is incorrect. Sir. So oxide forming tetrahedral void, we can leave it. Sir, what experiment says? That we will see. Experiment says that oxide forms FCC crystal structure in Na2O. Oxide forms FCC crystal structure. That is experimental result. So we will take experimental result. Experimental result says oxide forms FCC. So oxide ions occupy all the corners and all the face centers. It is the experimental result. Sir, that means oxide ions occupying corners means 8 corners, share is 1/8. Occupying face center 6, share is 1/2. Therefore, oxide ions will be 4 per unit cell. Then, experimental analysis says that Na plus ions occupy tetrahedral voids. Na plus ions occupy tetrahedral voids. Now you say Na plus ions occupy all the tetrahedral voids, otherwise alternate tetrahedral voids. What do you say? So, as per experiment, oxide forms FCC. So, oxide occupies all the corners and face centers. Okay, so oxide is like this. Na plus is occupying all the tetrahedral voids. Sir, okay. Now we can say, so per unit cell, if you see, oxide ions 4, because like this we calculation we got. Then sodium ions occupying tetrahedral voids, a tetrahedral voids 8. Therefore, the formula is Na2O, so it is correct. Okay, now we have to say about coordination number. We have to say about coordination number. Coordination number of Na plus we have to say, and oxide we have to say. Coordination number of Na plus we have to say, and coordination number of oxide we have to say. Now you say coordination number of Na plus. Na plus is present at where you see Na plus is present at tetrahedral void. Na plus is present at tetrahedral void. tetrahedral void is enclosed by four particles. So you say coordination number of Na plus. Sir, you are saying that coordination number of Na plus is 4. Then oxide. Coordination number of oxide, we have to say oxide is forming FCC. Oxide is occupying all the corners and face centers. Now, in the FCC unit cell, in the FCC lattice, each particle is in contact with 8 tetrahedral voids and 6 octahedral voids. Here, all the octahedral voids are occupied by Na plus ions. So, oxide ions are in contact with all the tetrahedral voids 8. So, its coordination number is 8. Okay. This is about sodium oxide crystal structure. Sir, next we will go for a cesium chloride crystal structure. Next, we will discuss about cesium chloride crystal structure. Cesium chloride, sir. Now, you say cesium chloride crystal comes under which type of crystal? Cesium chloride comes under which type of crystal structure? Cesium chloride comes under which type of crystal structure? Sir, okay. Now we will take regarding cesium chloride. In cesium chloride, we are taking cesium chloride. In cesium chloride, we can say Cl minus ions occupy all corners. Cl minus ions occupy all corners. Cesium ions occupy body center. Cesium ions occupy body center. Sir. So in cesium chloride, Cl minus ions occupy all the corners. Cl minus ions occupy all the corners and cesium ions occupy body center. Cesium ions occupy body center, that we said. Sir. So we are saying that Cl minus ions occupy all the corners, we said. Cesium ions occupying body center, we are saying. Cesium ions occupying body center. Okay. Now we will write regarding Cl minus and cesium ions, we will write Cl minus ion occupying corners. Okay. Cl minus ion occupying corners. Okay, we have written Cl minus ions occupying corners. Sir. 8 corners we have given. Then we have to talk about cesium ion. Cesium ion occupying body center. Okay. Cesium ion occupying body center we have given. So in cesium chloride, Cl minus ions occupying corners. So in the corners, we placed Cl minus ions. Cesium ion occupying body center. So at body center, cesium ion is placed. Now you say, what is the type of crystal structure cesium chloride comes? Is it coming FCC? Is it coming HCP? Is it coming simple cubic? Okay, you are saying that it is body-centered cubic. You are correct, sir. So you are saying that it is body-centered cubic, sir. Okay. So cesium chloride, we can say body-centered cubic. In this, we said Cl minus ions occupying corners and cesium ions occupying body centers, sir. It is a one unit cell of cesium chloride. Now we will see cesium chloride lattice. Let us go for cesium chloride lattice. Now we will take a cesium chloride lattice. In that lattice, we will take cesium chloride lattice. First, we will place Cl minus ions. We will place. Okay. One Cl minus, second Cl minus, third Cl minus, fourth, fifth Cl minus, sixth Cl minus, seventh, eighth Cl minus ions we place. Then in this unit cell, it is one unit cell. We placed Cl minus ions. This is one unit cell. Okay. In this unit cell, at body center we will place cesium ion. Okay. So at body center we are placing cesium ion. At body center we placed cesium ion. You said cesium chloride is BCC. So we placed Cl minus ions in the corners. Cesium ion in the body center we placed. It is one unit cell. We are discussing about lattice. Lattice consists of infinity number of unit cells. So we will go to second unit cell now. So second unit cell, corner Cl minus, corner. Okay. Now in the second unit cell, at body center, we will place cesium ion. At second unit cell, at body center, we will keep cesium ion. Okay. Then we will go for third unit cell. Third unit cell corner. In the third unit cell corners, we are placing Cl minus ions. In the third unit cell, at body center, we will place cesium ion. Next, we will go for fourth unit cell. Fourth unit cell corners, we will place Cl minus ions. Okay. At body center, we will place cesium ion. At body center, we are placing cesium ion. We will place. Sir, next we will go for fifth unit cell. In fifth unit cell corners, we will place Cl minus ions. Then we will take body center. In the body center, we will place cesium ion. In the body center, we placed cesium ion. Next, we will go for sixth unit cell. In the sixth unit cell corners, we will place Cl minus ions. At body center, we will keep cesium ion. Okay. Next, we will go for seventh unit cell. In seventh unit cell corners, we will place Cl minus ions. In that seventh unit cell, at the body center, we will keep cesium ion. At the body center, we are keeping cesium ion. Then we will go to eighth unit cell. Eighth unit cell corners, we will place Cl minus ions. At body center, we will place cesium ion. At body center, we place cesium ion. Okay, completed. So now we completed this. It is like this. It will continue. Just we said eight unit cells. We said lattice in the sense infinity number of unit cells. Therefore, it will continue, sir. So just how lattice will be there? That in that point of view, we discussed this cesium chloride, sir. Now we will see unit cell. We'll see. Sir, we have taken this unit cell. So understand that ionic compound means cation will be in contact with anion. Cation will be in contact with anion. Okay. Now you say that now we are taking this BCC. In this BCC, we have taken this cesium ion. This cesium ion is in contact with the Cl minus ions. Now you say, what is the coordination number of? What is the coordination number of cesium ion in the lattice? In the lattice, what is the coordination number of cesium ion in the lattice? What do you say? What is the coordination number of cesium ion in the lattice? Means you are saying 8. Sir, okay. So you said the coordination number of cesium ion in the lattice is 8. You said okay. Next, we will see coordination number of Cl minus ion. We will see. So now we have taken this. So we have taken this one. We took this one. You say coordination number of Cl minus ion. Okay. So now we will see coordination number of Cl minus ion in the lattice. Coordination number of Cl minus ion in the lattice. Okay. That you are saying that 4, we will check whether it is 4 or not, we will check it. Now we will see this one. You take any one of the Cl minus you take. Now you take this Cl minus. This Cl minus is in contact with how many cubes you see in the lattice. Suppose you take this Cl minus. This Cl minus is in contact with how many cubes you see? At center of each cube, body center is there. In the body center, cesium ion is there. Now you see this Cl minus. This Cl minus is in contact with how many cubes you are saying here? This Cl minus, tick mark Cl minus you consider. This tick mark Cl minus is completely enclosed by unit cells. It can't go for any more unit cell. This Cl minus is completely enclosed by unit cells. So this Cl minus is in contact with 8 cubes. In each cube, center point is called body center. In that, cesium ion is there. Therefore, Cl minus is in contact with how many cesium ions? Means 8 cesium ions. So coordination number of Cl minus in the lattice is how much? Means 8. Sir, so we discussed cesium chloride is coming under BCC crystal structure. In that, coordination number of cesium ion is 8. Coordination number of Cl minus ion is 8. Sir, so coordination number of cesium ion, coordination number of Cl minus ion, we completed. Sir, we have completed coordination number of cesium ion and coordination number of Cl minus ion, we completed. Okay. Next, we will see per unit cell how many species will be there. That we will see. Per unit cell. We'll go for per unit cell. We'll go. So per unit cell we'll take. Per unit cell. First we'll see cesium ion. Cesium ion is occupying body center. So per unit cell one body center will be there. Body center gives full share. Therefore one cesium ion. Then we'll take Cl minus ion. Cl minus ions occupying corners. Corners are 8. Share is 1 by 8. Therefore is equal to 1. So cesium ion is 1. Cl minus ion is 1. So formula is CsCl is the formula for cesium chloride. Sorry, okay. Next. Next, you say this point. Here you said in cesium chloride, Cl minus ions occupy all the corners and cesium ions occupy body center. Shall we say cesium ions occupy corners, occupy all corners, and Cl minus ions occupy body centers. Shall we say or we should not say? In this point of view, we are not saying any doubt. This is correct only. Okay, this is correct only. There is no doubt. Now we are going for alternative possibilities. That's all. So now I am saying this point. Whether shall we say this or we should not say? Shall we say cesium ions occupy all corners and Cl minus ions occupy body centers? Can we say or we cannot say? What do you say? Here we are saying that cesium ions occupy all corners. Cesium ions occupy all corners and Cl minus ions occupy body centers. Can we say this point or we should not say this point? What do you say? Can we say like this or we should not say? Sir. Okay, we will check. Whether it is correct or wrong, we will check it. Now we will see. Here, I will consider cesium ions. Now I am going to consider cesium ions. Let me join the points of cesium ions. Now you see, we have joined the cesium ions. Have we got cube? In this cube, center is called body center. In the body center, what is there? You see, we joined cesium ions, and joining the cesium ions, we got a cube. At the corners of the cube, what is there? You see, in this colored cube, in this green color, rose color, we have drawn, no? Green color, rose color, black color, like this. That cube, you see, in that cube corner, you see, see the corner. At corner, what is there? You see, for this cube corner is there, no? At corner, cesium ion is there. Okay. This blue color ball is there, no? Blue color ball. Is it a body center of this cube? That blue color ball, shall we say body center of this cube? Now you say, shall we say cesium ions occupy corners and Cl minus ion occupy body center? Yes or no? That you see. You have seen this one. Now you come to this point, sir. So you are saying that you are saying that cesium ions occupy all corners and Cl minus ions occupy body center. Okay. So in the textbook, what is there means cesium chloride will be given like this in the textbook. In the Cl minus ions occupy all corners and cesium ions occupy body center. It is a textbook concept. Suppose in the entrance, if they give like this point, if they give like this point, this is also correct. Sorry, okay. So we can say in any way, but in a book point of view, we will see in the book what is printed means this is printed. So we will take this one. So this is printed in the book. So we will take this one. Suppose in the question, if they ask like this, if they give like this statement, this is also correct. That we have to understand it. This we have to keep in mind. That's all. Sir, okay. So now regarding crystal structures, topic is completed. Next we will go for in the solid state. Next topic we will take. The next topic is what means semiconductors. Next topic is semiconductors we will take. So we are taking semiconductors. So what is semiconductors? How the conductivity of this will be there when compared with the insulators and conductors? That we'll see. So conductors we'll take. Conductors. Semiconductors will have conductivity. Semiconductors will have conductivity lower than that of conductors. Conductors is having higher conductivity. Conductors are having higher conductivity. Semiconductors are having lower conductivity. Then we'll see insulators. Insulators are having conductivity still low. So conductivity of semiconductors coming in between insulators and conductors. Conductivity of semiconductors is greater than insulators and less than conductors. Sir, okay. Then in semiconductors, two types are possible. In semiconductors, two types are possible. One is called intrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor. Another one is called extrinsic semiconductor. Now, intrinsic semiconductor is called intrinsic semiconductor means pure semiconductor. Pure semiconductor is called intrinsic semiconductor. Pure semiconductor is called intrinsic semiconductor. Extrinsic semiconductor means impurity will be there. Extrinsic semiconductor means impurity will be present. Sir, okay. So intrinsic semiconductor is called a pure semiconductor. For this example, we can say group 4. Group 4 is an example. Group 4A, that is a silicon, germanium, like this example for this. So pure semiconductor is called intrinsic semiconductor. For this example is group 4A, silicon, germanium coming under this category. Okay. Now we will take a silicon crystal. We will take this pure semiconductor example. We will take silicon. So we will take silicon crystal. We have taken silicon crystal. Now you say, what is the structure of silicon crystal? What is the structure of silicon crystal? Do you say? What is the structure of crystal, silicon crystal? Do you say simple cubic? Do you say body centered cubic? Do you say face centered cubic? Do you say HCP? Do you say octahedron? Do you say octahedron? Do you say tetrahedron? What do you say? what is the crystal structure of a silicon crystal? Sir, okay, we will check. What is the crystal structure of silicon crystal? That we will check it. Now we will take silicon. Silicon we have taken. Silicon comes under group number 4A. So this valence shell contains 4 electrons. So 4 electrons we will write. We have written 4 electrons. This valence shell is having 4 electrons. So it is in need of 4 electrons to get octet. It is in need of 4 electrons to get octet. Sir, okay. We will take in the silicon crystal only silicon atoms will be there. We will take another silicon atom. That is, that valence shell is having 4 electrons. Next silicon atom, this valence shell is having 4 electrons. Next silicon atom, this valence shell is having 4 electrons. Now we can conclude that this silicon is in need of 4 electrons because this valence shell is having 4 electrons. So it wants to get octet. This silicon atom valence shell is having 4 electrons because it is coming under group number 4A. So it is in need of 4 electrons to get octet. So it is going for sharing with this silicon. So due to this sharing, it has got 1 electron from this silicon. Now it is going for sharing. Due to that, it has got another electron. Now it is going for sharing. Due to that, it has got another electron. Now it is going for a sharing with another silicon. So it has got another electron. Now this silicon valence shell, 4 electrons, all the 4 electrons have gone for bonding with the neighboring silicon atoms. In this silicon comes under group 4A. So this valence shell is having 4 electrons. All the 4 electrons have gone for sharing with the neighboring silicon atoms. Therefore, this silicon has got 4 bonds. 4 bonds means 8 electrons. 8 electrons means octet. Therefore, it is stable. Now you say that, what about silicon? We said, how this silicon has behaved, in that way only this silicon also behaved. So, okay. So how it has behaved, in that only it will behave. So you are saying that silicon crystal comes under tetrahedral. Sir, so we came to know the structure of silicon crystal. Silicon crystal comes under tetrahedral, we said. Now we will take silicon crystal, we will say. Okay, we will write silicon crystal, we will take. In silicon crystal, silicon atoms arranged in a regular manner, that means giving tetrahedral structure. So each silicon is surrounded by 4 bonds. Each silicon atom is surrounded by 4 covalent bonds, we can say. Now in the lattice, we have taken a part. It is a part of the lattice, sir. Now it is a, which means it is semiconductor. Now for semiconductor, we have considered this pure silicon as an example. This pure silicon is the intrinsic semiconductor. What about its conductivity on changing temperature? That we will see. On rising the temperature, conductivity of this intrinsic semiconductor, what will happen? On rising the temperature, conductivity of this intrinsic semiconductor, what happens? That we will see. Okay, so for the now, what is the question means? On rising the temperature, what happens to the conductivity of this intrinsic semiconductor? Okay, what will happen? That we'll see. Now, what the experiment says? Experiment says conductivity increases. Sir, now we will take. What we have to take means, one is metallic conductors. Now we will take metallic conductors. Metallic conductors means, for example, copper metal, aluminium metal, like this. Metallic conductors, copper metal, like this, we said. Next we will take electrolytic conductors. Electrolytic conductors means, for example, copper sulfate aqueous solution. This is what means electrolytic conductors. Electrolytic conductors means example is copper sulfate solution. On raising the temperature, what happens to the conductivity? That we'll see. On raising the temperature, what happens to the conductivity? So here, what happens to the conductivity means we discussed that conductivity decreases. Why? Because resistance increases. So here, for electrolytic solution, what happens to the conductivity? What happens to the conductivity? We discussed that increases. Why? Because movement of ions get fastened. Movement of ions get fastened, therefore. So, conductivity of metallic conductors decreases with rise in temperature because resistance increases. Conductivity of electrolytic solutions increases because ions are moving fast. Now, regarding semiconductors, here intrinsic semiconductor. On rising temperature, conductivity of intrinsic semiconductor increases. It is solid. Pure silicon is a solid. Silicon crystal is a solid. Now you say, what may be the reason? In the metallic conductors means generally metals are solids. For metallic conductors, conductivity decreases on rising temperature because resistance increases. For electrolytic solutions, conductivity increases because ions are moving fast. For pure silicon, it is a solid. It is coming under intrinsic semiconductor. For this, conductivity rises on rising temperature. Why is it so? What may be the reason? What is the reason? Sir, here conductivity increases means first we have to see which is carrying current. You have to see here which will carry current here. In this one, which is carrying current? In this metallic conductors, which is carrying current? Free electrons are carrying current. In electrolytic solutions, which is carrying current? Ions are carrying current. Otherwise, molecules are carrying current. In this pure silicon, it is intrinsic semiconductor, which will carry current? Which will carry current? One possibility, electrons. We cannot say free electrons. Why we cannot say free electrons? Silicon is not metal. Silicon is not metal. That's why it is not, we cannot say free electrons. Sorry. You are saying that the silicon is not metal. Therefore, we cannot say free electrons. You are saying no. Then how did you use this word? You used this word in graphite. Why did you use this graphite? You may be asking this question. Graphite is a carbon. Graphite is element. It is non-metal. It is a good conductor of electricity. It is good conductor of electricity because it is having free electrons. Why did you use this word? You may be asking this question. Graphite is a carbon. Graphite is element. It is non-metal. It is a good conductor, exception. Here we are saying, here how did you say free electrons? So this word is a superficial word. It is not actual word. Free electrons in graphite, free electrons we are saying means it is superficial word. It is not actual word. What is actual? In this graphite, you are saying that you are correct. Graphite comes under layer like structure. In each layer, above and below, delocalized pi electron cloud is present. Delocalized pi electron cloud. Okay. So in examination, four options will be given. Graphite is a good conductor because, okay, because in the four options, only free electron is the correct means you have to tick the free electron. If a delocalized pi electron given, then you have to tick delocalized pi electron. Okay. Suppose they are asking the question, graphite is a good conductor due to migration of ions. Due to migration of atoms, due to migration of free electrons, due to presence of free electrons. Okay. due to presence of three electrons? None. If options are like this, then we have to tick three electrons. Okay, they are asking questions superficially, so we are saying answer superficially. That's all. If we go deep, then we have to say delocalized pi electron. Okay, so depending on the place means in what way the question is there, as per that we have to say the answer. That is also we have to keep in mind. We should not go for argument in that place. Okay, sorry. We have taken this intrinsic semiconductor. This is pure silicon. It is solid. It is showing it is carrying current. It is carrying current means which can carry current? Electrons only can carry current. In that there is no doubt. Which electrons can carry current means only possibility valence electrons. Inner electrons cannot carry current. Only valence electrons can carry current. Sir, valence electrons. Now valence electrons for silicon. Valence electrons for silicon means 4. Valence electrons for silicon means 4. The 4 are like this. All the valence electrons are covalently bonded. All the valence electrons are covalently bonded. On rising the temperature, conductivity increases. So in the pure silicon, which will carry current means no doubt valence electrons. That means bonded electrons. No doubt bonded electrons. In the pure silicon, bonded electrons carry current, it is confirmed. Now on rising the temperature, conductivity increases. That means what will happen to this bond such that conductivity increases on rising temperature? We came to conclusion, in this pure silicon, bonding electrons responsible for conductivity. On rising temperature, conductivity increases because bond breaks. You are correct. Okay, so on rising temperature, why conductivity increases means bond breaks, so electrons become free. Therefore, since it is becoming free, it is carrying current, so that conductivity increases. Sir, okay. This is about intrinsic semiconductor. Okay. Next we'll go for extrinsic semiconductor. We'll go. Extrinsic semiconductor means impurity should be there. Okay. So first we will take intrinsic semiconductor. Intrinsic semiconductor means it is a pure semiconductor. Pure semiconductor. To this, let us add impurity. Let us add impurity. What we will get means we will get extrinsic semiconductor. We will get extrinsic semiconductor. We got extrinsic semiconductor. Now, intrinsic semiconductor comes under group 4A. Example is what means silicon or germanium. Pure silicon or pure germanium is example for intrinsic semiconductor. To this you are adding impurity and you are getting extrinsic semiconductor. This process is called doping. Now, which impurity let us add with respect to group number? Here you are saying group 4, you know, like this. Which impurity? The impurity comes under which group? A group. Which group? Such that we will get extrinsic semiconductor. Sir, in extrinsic semiconductor, which will carry current? In extrinsic semiconductor, which will carry current? Okay. Extrinsic semiconductor is a solid. Therefore, which will carry current? Electrons will carry current. Which electrons? No doubt valence electrons. Inner electrons will not come for carrying current. So valence electrons carry current. Is there any other possibility? No doubt valence electrons carry current in extrinsic semiconductor. Is there any other which is responsible for carrying current in extrinsic semiconductor?